Hi, this is Jitesh Satyan. WhatsApp number +91 965 66 11 829. Today's talk is on cleaning of nadis, Nadi Shuddhi. Without Nadi Shuddhi, progress in pranayama and meditation is not possible. Hatha Pradipika and Goraksha Shataka explicitly state that if the nadis have impurities, then prana will not travel the middle path. Nadis are sukshma energy channels. There are 72,000 main nadis each on the left and right side of the body. With these nadis end with even more fine branches. Among these, 14 are considered important in tantric practice. These 14 are Ida, Pingala, Sushumna, Saraswati, Varuni, Pusha, Hasti Jihva, Yashaswini, Vishwodhara, Kuhu, Shankhini, Payaswini, Alambusha, and Gandhari. For Nadi Shuddhi practice, we will focus on Ida, Pingala and Sushumna nadis. There are several scriptures that describe the position of the different nadis. For the practice that we will discuss, it is enough to understand that Ida is associated with the left side dominant breathing, Pingala to right side dominant breathing, and Sushumna when both side flow is either not felt or equal flow without any dominance on one side. The moon or the nourishing energy flows through Ida, while the burning or utilizing energy is the sun or Surya Nadi, which is Pingala. Sushumna is the path of yogi, where movement of Kundalini energy leads to spiritual progress. Mukti Marga Sushumna. Now we'll discuss the two practices. Okay, so the first practice. In the first practice, the first week, start with inhale and exhale without any retention with deep breathing thrice. When you exhale, don't wait for all air to flow. Start inhaling before you completely breathe out. Same applies to inhale. So that's how you are able to avoid any retention. So it should start the first week with inhale and exhale without any retention, which is achieved by starting the inhalation before you completely exhale. And saying, before you completely inhale, before you are stuck, you should start exhaling. So ensure you start exhaling before you are full with air. Three continuous inhale and exhale without retention. So focus is essential to avoid retention. Also, breathing inhale and exhale should be as a continuous stream. There should not be breaks. Then proceed to inhale and exhale of 16 mental count each without retention. Again, thrice. Similar to deep breaths without count of having continuous streams. So it's initially three times without any break, where you are focusing only on deep breath, and then you do it with the deep breaths which has a count of 16. Do this for 24 count and finally for 32 count as well. The count speed can be adjusted so that 32 count is only around 16 to 20 seconds. So it's around 16 to 20 seconds to achieve 32 count. So approximately 2 counts can be achieved per second. And slow the count only based on the comfort level. So it's assumed that the person is comfortable with 32 count based on the practice discussed in previous talks to steadily increase the capacity to 32 count. And the second week onwards, inhale, retention and exhale is practiced in the ratio 1:4:2. 3 continuous cycles before taking any break. So the second week, the count is 8:32:16. The third week, it is 12:48:24. And the fourth week, it will be 16:64:32. Proceed to higher level each week only when you are comfortable about the increase in number. The final week, the 16 inhale is done in left nose, 64 retention and 32 exhale in the right nose. So till first 4 weeks, you are not focusing on a specific nose. So let's say the second week, 8:32:16. You are doing it in terms of getting the inhale to 8 count, retention to 32 count and exhale to 16 count. So it does not focus on the left nose or the right nose. But after the first 4 weeks, the final week, now you focus on the specific nose. So final week, 16 inhale is done on left nose, 64 retention and 32 exhale is done on the right nose, followed by few seconds of normal breathing, and then you do it on the opposite side. So 16 inhale from right nose, 64 retention and 32 exhale from next nose, which is the left nose. Again, few second break, and then you repeat it thrice. So final week, again, it's 16 inhale is done in the left nose, 64 retention and 32 exhale in the right nose, followed by few seconds of normal breathing, and then 16 inhale from the right nose, 64 retention and 32 exhale from the left nose, followed by few seconds break, and you do it 3 times. Okay, so point to note is the spine should be held erect while doing this particular practice. Do it in a comfortable asana or a seating posture, and use abdominal breathing. That is, chest region remains steady while breathing, and abdomen expands on inhale and contracts on exhale. So I repeat, when you inhale, the abdomen expands, and when it should contract while you exhale, contract inwards. So your shoulder or chest region is actually not moving. It's the abdominal breathing that you do. Do not stress yourself. Increasing count should be achieved with practice and not with stress on body parts. So we mentioned about mental count to 16, 32, all these counts. So mental count can be done with Bija Shreem, accompanied with fingers to maintain the count. So mentally you will say, you will actually say Shreem, 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 and you can use your fingers in order to balance the count, in order to ensure how many times you have done it. It is fine if you sweat while doing Nadi Shuddhi practice, which is quite normal. Now there are 2 practices to be done each week. So we'll now look at the second practice. So this has 3 steps. Step 1 is for Ida Nadi, step 2 for Pingala Nadi, and step 3 is for Sushumna. So step 1, take a deep breath in, close the right nose with finger press by the side of the tip of the nose, mentally chant Am 3 times while exhaling without break through the left nostril. Without releasing the finger, Closing the right nostril. Mentally chant six times while inhaling without break from the left nostril. Now retain by closing both nose, by pressing on the sides of both nose and mentally chanting 12 times, and exhale through the right nose, keeping the left nose closed. So what we said is exhale from left, inhale from left, retain, and then exhale through right. All this is done with Step 2 is for Pingala Nadi. So the process and the count remains the same as for Ida. However, is replaced with and the nose side is switched. So take a deep breath. Exhale from right, three times mentally. Inhale from right, six times mentally. Retain, 12 times, and then exhale through left. Breathing is always continuous. Now finally coming to step 3, which is focused on Sushumna entry. So here you need to inhale in 2 steps. So inhalation is done with 6 times while inhaling through the left, followed by 6 times while inhaling through the right. So you have inhaled through the left with inhaled through the right with and then you retain and mentally count for 12 times during retention. During retention, with closed eyes, visualize prana entry in Sushumna at the Mooladhara. Now very slowly release the breath, like it is passing through a thread through the spine. And rather than moving out through the nose, it should be focused upward. So it moves up, and rather than coming out through the nose, it's moving through the spine. And rather than coming out through the nose, you try to focus it upwards to the center on top of the head. So we used mam, like the words which are used in om. A, u, ma. Mam. So perform this 3 times. Steps 1, 2 and 3. First one was for Ida Nadi with Second one was for Pingala Nadi with And the third one used and mam for Sushumna Nadi. Okay. Now benefits of Nadi Shuddhi is internal cleansing for pranayama and dhyana. A glow in the face will start coming after a few weeks of practice. Problems like pain in specific parts of the body which did not have any cause identified in a medical diagnosis will tend to disappear. Like let's say the checkup showed no issues, but you had a feeling that there was pain or something wrong or some wrong condition in a specific body part. Those kind of issues will disappear, which would be a result of energy getting blocked in specific parts. So that will be completely moved with Nadi Shuddhi. There will be a glow in the face. Overall health will improve. Definitely that will ensure that you are able to do proper pranayama and meditation as we go forward. Ensure Nadi Shuddhi practice is only done in empty stomach and without any stress or exertion. Thanks for listening.